Hey, what's up? Welcome to a new quick edit video, this time with an image from another spot which I wanted to visit for a long time. Here you can see the Hintersee in the Berchtesgaden area in southern Germany during sunrise. And for this video I mainly want to use Lightroom for the editing, since there isn't really much to do. But before I start, let's first check out the before and after images. And as always, I'm starting in the lens correction tab by activating those two settings. As you can see, the enable profile corrections already help reduce the vignetting a little bit. Then let's go back to the top. And for the camera profile, I'm going with Adobe Standard. This will help restore detail from the darker areas and reduce the contrast a little bit, which means I simply have more control over the contrast myself. Then let's also switch the white balance to daylight. This will cool down the image a little bit while I still have some nice warm highlights in there. And then let's further work on the colors by increasing the vibrance. Now this might look a little bit too saturated, but I will reduce the blue color saturation later. I just boosted the vibrance this much to have some nice green and yellow color tones in the highlights in the center part. Now that's already it for the global adjustments for this image. Most of the editing will be done using local adjustments, so let's start by going to the gradiated filters. Here you can see I already have applied two of those. So let's start with the bottom one first. And right now this area is a bit dark, so let's fix that by increasing the shadows. And let's also increase the whites for some more brightness. Okay, looks good already, but I still want to further boost the reflection in the water a little bit and also get some details in the rocks in the foreground. And an easy way to do that is to simply increase the clarity. Just be careful to not overdo it. Then let's go to the next gradiated filter for the sky part. And as you can see on the left side of the image, the highlights are quite heavy. Still, they aren't overexposed, but I still want to fix them by dropping the highlights. And then I want to soften this area a little bit to just create some fake glow effect. But instead of increasing the blacks like I usually do for the glow, I'm this time decreasing the clarity a little bit. And let's also decrease the dehaze, which will brighten up this area again. Alright, then let's go to the radial filters. As you can see, I have applied quite a few of those. So let's start with the upper one first. This one is mainly for the mountain peaks in the back, which I think don't have enough detail right now. So let's fix that by increasing the texture. And let's also increase the clarity. And I think I can go all the way up here and get some nice detail in there without overdoing it. Then let's work on the left side for a minute. Here I want to enhance the glow effect, and this time I'm increasing the blacks slightly. I'm also using negative dehaze again. And then last, I also want to warm up this area by simply increasing the temperature. Okay, nice. Then let's work on the center of the image for a little bit. Actually, I don't think I need to do much in here. I simply want to have some more structure going on in that area. So again, let's just increase the clarity. Also, I could warm up this area again by increasing the temperature. And this way we get some nice sunlight in there. Then let's also work on this little island in the center of the image. Right now it's super dark, but don't worry, we can fix it by simply increasing the shadows. Okay, then I also want to work on this rock in the near foreground. And here I simply want to add some more clarity. and maybe make it a bit brighter by increasing the whites. Alright, and since I think the scene is missing some fog over the water surface, I also created this radial filter, with which I want to create some fake fog. And you can do that super easy by simply decreasing the dehaze. And you can see this looks almost like real fog. Now the problem is negative dehaze will add some saturation to this area, so I need to fix that by simply dropping the saturation. Okay, looks nice. Now another problem is that the dehaze will go over those rocks on both sides, so I need to erase that part of the radial filter. And therefore, with the radial filter still selected, I can simply hit the brush button and then go down to erase. And then I'm simply painting over the area of the radial filter which I want to have erased on both sides. That's it for the local adjustments. Then let's continue with the color grading. And I actually want to just work in the saturation tab here. So let's get rid of some of the orange colors. And I don't want to have any aqua color tones, and reduce the blue ones as well. As I said earlier, I want to focus more on those warp color tones. So let's increase the yellow ones and the green ones. Okay. And then for the split toning, I'm going for a warm color tone for the highlights. And then choose a cold color tone for the shadows. Okay. And finally, I want to do a little bit of sharpening. And that's basically it for editing this image in Adobe Lightroom. Now, as you can see, there is still some vignetting going on, which I don't want to fix in Lightroom because I am probably not able to. So let's fix that real quick in Photoshop. And to fix that, I'm simply grabbing a spot healing brush and roughly paint over those corners. Actually, I could also use the clone stamp tool. Pick an area close by holding down the Alt key and clicking in there, and then just brush over the area I want to fix. And let's do that on the other side as well. I'm holding down the Alt key and click in this area and then just paint over the edge. Alright, and that's it for editing this sunrise mountain landscape from the Hintersee in Berchtesgaden. So I hope this was a helpful and interesting video. If you have any questions regarding the editing, then please let me know in the comments. And thank you very much for watching this video.